El Nuevo Sol Televisión.
Coming out to me personally means just telling those you love that you're gay and for them to know who you really are.
Yo ya sabía. Uno como madre sabe cuando los hijos son diferentes. Así es que, pues no me sorprendí así de que, uy, mi hijo es gay.
It's the worst feeling when people don't know.
Miraba unos videos y se ponía un suéter como que era el pelo y según él, su pelo lo tenía largo y bailaba. Yo nunca lo traté mal porque decía, no hagas eso, o no, nunca. O sea, yo siempre me reservaba, pero sí miraba que mi hijo era diferente.
I'm a twin. I have a twin brother. Growing up with a twin, actually, was very, very fun. His friends are now okay with it because he talks about it and he lets them know that he has a gay brother. In high school was probably one of the worst experiences ever because my own friend actually outed me to the entire school and bullied me, and she even wrote letters to me and anonymous letters threatening me just for being gay.
About the 1890s, German psychologists and German medical scientists kind of coined this term, homosexual, and homosexuality. So it actually becomes part of our consciousness.
Bienestar Familia ayuda a la comunidad latina, a la comunidad lésbico, gay, bisexual, transgénero y queer, y a las comunidades que han sido impactadas por el VIH a través de consejería comprensiva. También ofrecemos salud mental, ofrecemos grupos de apoyo y prevención.
¿O de dónde vienes, Ronnie? Oh, vengo de ver a mi psiquiatra, vengo de ver a mi psicólogo, ¿verdad? No es algo que se escucha mucho en la cultura latina, porque el minuto que alguien te escucha que estás viendo a un psicólogo, un psiquiatra, ¿cuál es la reacción que encontramos?
Estás loco.
O sea, yo con este, de parranda, ni loco.
If you're talking about a traditional immigrant family here in the United States that comes from Latin America, and that still endorses traditional values, they may have more conservative views about what it means to be a man or a woman.
Before 1973, homosexuality was considered a form of mental illness by the mental health community. And it was institutionalized as such by an instrument called the DSM, the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual.
Homosexuality and the attraction to same-sex gender is either innately part of who you are, tied to genetics and tied to your genes and your person, and the other argument is that those kinds of issues, gender construction and those kinds of norms, are dictated by society.
A small number of psychiatrists and psychologists continue to believe that loving people of the same sex constitutes a form of mental illness. And as such, they offer a treatment called conversion therapy.
The professional associations say that conversion therapy has been debunked. You're not going to change someone's, let's say, innate drives.
Worse, many mental health professionals believe that conversion therapy is actually damaging to the person who is attracted to people of the same sex because it creates a sense of shame.
Tenemos que aceptar a nuestros hijos como son. No son una enfermedad ni nada de eso, pues ellos son así que pues no los puedes cambiar.
In fact, going all the way back to Freud did not believe that it was possible to change the fundamental sexual orientation of an individual, although Freud also believed that most people were bisexual, were somewhere in the middle of the spectrum.
To legally allow gays and lesbians to marry in the United States is greatly impacting the perception of what it means to be gay and lesbian for immigrants that come to this country, as well as established Chicano and Latino communities. I think it's encouraging the humanization of people in our community. If you see someone as a human being, you no longer see them as this bad thing or as this stigma, because you see that this is, a human being who breathes and loves another human being just like you.
There are interesting arguments that I hear, that are being debated in the Supreme Court, especially a marriage as this institution is created for the propagation of the species, propagation of children. And I just think there are people who get married all the time, who not only are not interested in having children, are not capable of having children.
When we talk about religion in Western societies, we have to remember that there's not just one religion, and that religions differ in their attitude towards homosexuality. The predominant attitude in Judeo-Christian religions has not been one that is welcoming to homosexuality. However, there have been a number of changes in the attitudes of specific denominations through the years. So, for example, Dignity is a movement of gay and lesbian Catholics who seek to be Catholic, to continue to be Catholic while still being gay or lesbian.
We have found that there are many more Chicana and Chicano gay and lesbians who are writing. They're writing an array of textbooks and articles. I think there's a couple of themes that we see in those writings. The first one is that of autobiography, where people are sharing their stories and their experiences as gay men or as lesbian women in our community.
La mayoría de los pacientes, de nuestros clientes, son impactados por rechazo familiar. Rechazo familiar del cual no han hablado por muchos años. Y han acumulado depresión, han acumulado homofobia interna, transfobia interna.
People like Gloria Anzaldú and Sherry Moraga, they really talk about Chicana feminism and the need to, you know, fight for equal rights as well as a better understanding of sexism in our community, not just for lesbians, but for all women in our community.
Y si tienes un hijo, acéptalo como es y quiérelo. Eso es lo que yo hago, quiero a mis hijos, a los dos. No por ser uno gay y el otro no. Los dos para mí son iguales.
El ser padre o madre de un hijo LGBT no es cosa del otro mundo.